So basically, A is also one point on the circle. Its coordinate is 0, 0. B becomes a coordinate for you in the on the circumference of the circle. Coordinate is A, 0, and A is the intercept, and B is the intercept on the y-axis. So next coordinate is 0, B. So basically, you as per the equation of the circle, you have x minus h whole square plus y minus b, y minus k whole square is equal to r square, right? So in the place of x and y, you put first a comma 0, then 0 comma 0, and then 0 comma b. So you'll get three equations, and you have the three unknown variables because r square is also there, no? We need to find r square value also. Got it? So you, three things you need to find. First is h value, k value, and r value.
Okay, sir.
You understood, no? Any questions, any doubts?
Yeah. No, sir. I can do this, sir.
Now you can do that, right? This question is similar to your example, last example, which we did earlier, right? So here, case one, substitute, right? Case two, substitute B. B comma 0, and case 3, C 0 comma, no, this is 0 comma B, 0 comma B, and this is 0 comma 0, so you get the three things and to substitute and get the answers. So where is that? Once you substitute it, you'll get the three equations, three unknown variables, and we can do this. Just try it out. I'm sure you'll be able to get it. But if we don't get it, then I'll tell you how to do this.
Okay, sir.
Everything you need to get the value in terms of A and B, because that's what the data given to you. So radius also in terms of A and B, coordinates also in terms of A and B.
So I got the equations and I tried equating them.
Huh?
So at the end I got B square minus 2BH equals A square minus 2AH.
B square minus 2H and
B square minus 2H.
Okay, no problem. That's fine. So get the value of H and K. Once you get the value of H and K, you can substitute in the first equation when you substituted the coordinate as 0, 0. R square was equal to H square plus K square. So get everything data in terms of A and B. So H you got it. K also you'll get it. And R also you'll get it. Then just substitute. You should get the answer.
Okay.
Correct? You got A square minus 2AH is equal to 0, right? Correct?
Sorry?
You got A square minus 2AH is equal to 0, correct?
Sir, what is breaking my little
bit though? What I'm saying is, A square minus 2AH is equal to 0 you got, right?
It's equal to b square minus 2bh, sir. It will be r square. All of them will be equal to r square.
All will be equal to r square. No, no, no. First, when you substitute case 1, when you substituted a comma 0, what did you get? Achha, a comma 0. Okay, okay, correct. So that you a got comma equal to r square, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, no problem.
A minus h whole square plus 0 minus k whole square equals r square.
Oh, that's fine. That's fine. No problem. So basically, R square is nothing but H square plus K square. So get the equation in terms of H and K only. You'll get it. So both you got equal to R, you know.
Okay.
You know?
Yeah.
I think you got, when you substituted it, x is a minus h, so h minus a minus h whole square, right? A minus h, correct.
A square minus 2a should be equal to 0,
correct?
Okay, okay. So, same principle, b square minus 2a should also be 0,
yeah, correct. Same thing.
So R is 0, right? At the end? R square will be?
No, R is basically.
R square is 0.
R is nothing but H square plus K square, no?
Yeah.
Okay? R square is equal to H square plus K square. H square plus K square, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, so H and K value you get it. Substitute in the H square plus K square, you'll get the value of R square.
But now how I get H and K value, sir?
HK value you didn't get. Okay, okay. So I'll just tell you. You got the equation 0 minus H square. I'll just write
plus B minus K square equals R square.
Correct. 0 minus k, okay, to 0, okay, correct. So b minus k whole square is equal to r square, okay. So let me just write it this part and send it to you. then it will be easy for you, you know. And third equation was when you substituted the x square plus k square is equal to r square. So you got square, you got square, you got square. Okay, so you got three equations. If you just check here, you should get these three equations, isn't it? They are the three equations you have got it, right? Correct. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Now,
I've already gotten this one.
You already got it. Now, substitute the third equation in the first and second. Substitute r square as h square plus k square in the first and second. And then,
okay, sir.
See what you get. You should be able to get it then.
This will be a square minus 2ak to 2ah plus r square equals r square.
In the place of r square, you put h square plus k square, Vijay.
Okay.
So that, you know, we can subtract the equation then. Got it? I'll tell you how to do that. We'll subtract
the equation. Wait, so a square minus 2ah plus r plus h square plus k square.
Correct.
Okay. And b square minus 2ak plus r square equals h square plus k square.
Correct. So, when you subtract the equation, what do you get now?
Let's do after this.
Ah.
Subtract from. Oh, okay.
Because h square plus k square will get cancelled for you in the first equation. No?
Yeah.
Both sides will get cancelled to you, isn't it?
Yeah.
Then what is the final answer you will get? A square? A square minus 2ah should be equal to 0. That's what the first equation will lead you the answer, right?
Yeah.
Similarly, you do for the second equation.
B square minus 2ak equals to 0.
Excellent. So, a and h and k value, you get it now.
Yeah.
What is the value of h and k now?
Zero.
H and K is zero. Why?
Because everything comes out to be zero.
Oh, okay, okay. Wait, I'll just write it and send it to you. Otherwise, you are getting confused.
Yeah.
No problem. First one, I'll write it and send it to you so that, you know, it'll be easy for you.
Yes, sir.
A square minus 2h is equal to 0. So a minus 0, say a equal to 0, or a is equal to 2h, h is equal to a by 2. Okay, so I will just send you this part. Check the answer. Yeah, I sent you now through this Just check, which I sent you now. Did you get it now? A minus h whole square plus 0 minus k whole square is equal to r square. R square is h square plus k square. You expand it, h and k get cancelled. H is equal to a by 2. Similarly, you do okay. For the second also.
Okay, okay, sir.
K also you should get as b by 2 then.
Yeah, yes, yes, sir.
And what is r square
okay,
then?
Got it, sir.
R square is nothing but?
A by 2 whole square plus k b by 2 whole square.
Yeah, got it. Now we can form the equation of the circle then.
So it will be... So it will be x minus a by 2 whole square plus y minus b by 2 whole square equals a square plus b square by 4.
Yup, you got it. Clear. Yep. Understood this part?
Yes, understood.
Good. Any questions, any doubts in the any of this problem now? Everything done?
Yeah, done. All done.
All done. Excellent. Okay. This one you did? 15th one? Does this point minus 2.5 and 3.5 lie inside or outside the circle?
Yes, I have done that. It's inside the circle.
Excellent.
Because once if I input all the questions, it will be 18.5. 18.5 is question 25. So,
correct.
It will be inside the circle.
You got it now. So, basically, you just need to check the radius, huh? Distance from the center. If it is lesser, then it will be inside. If it is more, then it will be outside. Correct? Huh? Hmm. Okay, let's go to the parabola now. So, parabola. Can you quickly draw the figure 11.3 now? Figure 11.3.
Yes,
so, now once we draw the... We have heard many times the parabola, right? So, all the quadratic equations forms the parabola equations. Now, we'll go in detail about what is parabola and how to draw the parabola now. What is the equation of the parabola? Clear? And what are the terms gets evaluated in the parabola? Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Yeah, just draw the figure 11.13 now. And in the meantime, I'll just tell you. The parabola is of all the points in the plane that are equidistant from the fixed line and a fixed point not on the line in the plane. So the main thing we need to understand is this. What is this definition tells you? Parabola is a set of all the points in the plane that are equidistant from the fixed line and a fixed point, not on the line in the plane. Okay, so once you draw the figure 11.3, we'll try to relate this figure with the understanding, with the definition.
Okay.
Okay.
I'll do the figure, sir.
Yeah, just draw this figure now. So parabola is a set of points in the all the points in the plane that are equidistant from the fixed line. So what are the fixed line? Let's understand this part. So this is called the fixed line. Okay. Fixed line is L here. Okay. And what is this fixed point? This is the fixed point. Which are the set of all the points? These are the sets. These are the set of the points. Okay, good. So let's understand as per the definition. So it will be very clear to you. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Done? Okay, good. So as per the definition, we say parallel is set of all the points in the plane. So fixed point means what? See, fixed point is, which I, you know, drawn for you, it's a fixed point is the focus of the any parabola, and you have a fixed line in the plane, that is the line L. Can you see that? That is also called the directrix. The name given to the fixed line is called the directrix. Clear? So that is constant for all kinds of you know, conic sections. So this is called the directrix. And what are the set of points? Set of points on the parabola, that is fine, that is P1, P2, P3, correct? Okay. So you are in the parabola, you have a fixed point F, you know, such that, and there is a fixed line L. So basically what it means, they're equidistant from a fixed line and a fixed point. That means if fixed line is L, then the perpendicular distance of point P1 from B1 is P1, B1, isn't it?
Yeah.
Point, the fixed distance of the point P1 on the parabola from the line is B1. So that is P1, B1. Next, the fixed point from the P1 point distance from the focus is P1 F. So both are equal. Can you see that?
Yeah.
As per the definition, any point you take it. Okay. So we take, so first we took the point P1 on the parabola. So P1 distance from the line L will be P1 B1. And P1 distance from the fixed point F is P1 F. So both has to be equal. So that's the definition of the parabola, isn't it? Next, we'll consider the point P2 now. Distance of the P2 from the directrix of the line is P2 B. Distance from the fixed point is, focus is P2 F. So both has to be same. So P2 also has to be same, isn't it?
Yeah.
Any point we'll consider. Any point we consider. So P3 also will be fixed then. So P3 to F and P3 to B3, that also has to be same. So that's the actual definition for the parabola. Clear?
Yes, sir, clear.
Okay, next point. So what are the three terms we got in the, you know, parabola now? One is the fixed line, that's called directrix, and another is a fixed point, that's called the focus. Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, if the fixed point lies on the fixed line, then set of points in the plane which are equidistant from the fixed point, and the fixed line is a straight line through with a fixed point perpendicular to the fixed line, we call this as a straight line as degenerate case of parabola. What is called degenerate case of parabola? See, what we are saying is, if the fixed point, if the F lies on the L only, if you consider the focus lies on the line L, okay, straight line, and which is perpendicular to the fixed line, you know, because it's perpendicular to the fixed line, we call this straight line as degenerate case of the parabola. So basically, that what kind of parabola will be existing in this case now, because any point perpendicular and you have the point P1 again to the focus F, so that will not be a, you know, case of the parabola then, isn't it? Degenerate case of the parabola, because it's not getting generated, because once you have the point P and the focus is also on this line, so the distance will be very different, no? Because P1 F and P1 B1 will not become the equal, isn't it? Because they are all in the same line. If they are on the same line, then how can the two distance will be the same then, isn't it? So that's why it's called as a degenerate case of the parabola. Clear?
Yes, sir, clear.
Next, a line through the focus perpendicular directrix is called the axis of the parabola, and the point of intersection of parabola with axis is called the vertex. Now let's understand what is going on. So draw the figure 11.14 now. On the example 14, now we'll try to understand what are the different terms we define in the case of the parabola. Till now we understood only focus and the directrix, isn't it? Directrix was a straight line and the focus was a fixed point, you know, from the parabola, not on the straight line. And then the any point, set of points on the parabola was equidistant from the line as well as the focus. Clear? Now we'll define the something called the vertex and something called the axis. These are two things we need to define.
Okay, sir, done.
Done?
Yeah.
Good. Now, what is the meaning in this case? Okay, so let's understand this part. Now, any line which is basically passing through the focus and is perpendicular to the line, that is called the axis. Clear? Any line which passes through the focus and perpendicular to the directrix is called the axis. And when the parabola touches on this axis, that point is called the vertex. Clear? That point is called the vertex. Clear this part? This is what we need to. So for parabola, one, you know, what are the four things we got it? One is vertex, axis, focus, and directrix. They are the four terminologies we should remember for the parabola. Clear? Okay, now let's go to the standard equation of the parabola now. The equation of the parabola is simplest. Draw the figure, you know, this 11. What is it? 11.15 A part. 11.15 A part.
Okay,
done. Okay, now in this case, let's see. So here focus is A comma 0. What is the directrix line? Directrix line is, you have x is equal to minus A. Can you see that? X is equal to minus A. So that line is basically perpendicular to the x axis and at a distance A from the y axis. This distance is A from the y axis, isn't it? Because you know, and this distance is A from the y axis, and this is the origin. If we just see, this is the 0 comma 0 and in the Cartesian coordinate, right? X axis and y axis is given to you. And what else becomes here? Let's write, send it to you this part so that it'll be more clear to you. Now, so 0 comma 0 is the origin for you, and the directrix is x equal to minus a, and focus is a comma 0. So your thing is clear. Vertex is 0 comma 0, focus a comma 0, line is x equal to minus a. So the simplest equation of the parabola of line is y square is equal to 4ax. So why it is y square is equal to 4, this is the equation of the line. We'll come back on this, how to derive the equation of the parabola. But right now just understand this. The equation of the parabola y square is equal to 4ax. So y square, you know. So when you have the y square is equal to 4ax, that means you know, y value. Y value will be what? Square root of 4ax. You know? Isn't it?
Yeah.
Or you can write it like x is equal to y square by 4a. You can just write it like, I'll tell you how it is. Huh? So simplest way to understand is, whenever they give y square is equal to 4a, so this can be written as x is equal to y square by 4a. Okay? So,
okay.
Y square by 4a. So in this, you keep on substituting the value of y. Y can be positive or y can be negative. So the moment y can be positive or negative, because 4a is anyway constant. So it's a quadratic equation now. So any positive values or any negative values of the y will give you the curve on the positive x-axis only. Correct?
Okay.
So if you see that the curve is going towards the right hand side. Right hand side means what? When the y is positive on the positive axis, it is going towards the positive x-axis. When the y is negative, x is still going on the positive x-axis. Correct?
Yeah.
Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Right? Because y square is anyway all the point positive, right? So, if y is positive, x equal to positive only. If y is negative, x is equal to still positive. So it is in the positive x-axis. Understood this part? Clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay, excellent. Now draw the B part now. Let's understand the B part now. When the BY square is equal to minus 4AX now. So here in this part, what will be the distance, right? So let's understand this part. Here x is equal to a, this is the distance x is equal to a, and then you have focus here, you have 0 comma 0 origin, drawn the figure now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, now in this case, let's understand. Now, the equation of the parabola is y square minus 4ax. Now, it's negative 4ax, minus 4ax. So, we saw that if y was positive, in the previous figure, we saw that even if the value of y was positive or negative, x was always the positive. Now, even if the y is positive or negative, x will be always negative because minus is getting multiplied with the y square, isn't it? So, I can write it as x is equal to, I sent you, x is equal to minus y square by 4a.
Yeah.
So, the graph remains the same, isn't it?
Yeah.
Graph remains the same. So, what will happen if y is positive, then x will be anyway negative only, because even if the negative sign is multiplied, y square will be anyway positive only, but x to anyway will get become the negative only because minus y will. That's why all the values of x is negative in this case. Can you see that on this parabola? That's why it's a, you know, just a mirror image of the previous parabola, because any value of the y on the positive y axis or the negative y axis, when you substitute, you will get the x value as negative. So x value is negative on the left hand side of the Cartesian coordinate. So that's the reason you have the left hand side graph of the parabola. Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Till now, any questions, any doubt?
No, sir.
Excellent. Now we'll go to the equation of the figure 11.15 C part now. This you need to explain to me. This C part, you can explain me. This x square is equal to 4ay. Draw the figure and then we'll try to understand how it is done. What is the equation of the directrix line and then vertex, and then we'll do, right? Yeah, can you explain me the how the equation of the parabola x square is equal to 4ay, it is going above the x axis, right?
Okay, so in this one, the parabola is above the x axis.
Correct.
And it's 4ay because well, it's a positive part of the y axis. Like.
Correct. Yes. So directrix line is on the y equal to minus a, right? So we can easily form that. Focus is at 0, a, that is on the positive y axis, and then your equation of the parabola will be x square is equal to 4ay. So y will be equal to x square by 4a. So even if you have negative and positive value of x, the y will be anyway always positive. Correct. Similarly, the opposite case is on the D part.
Yes.
Just negative sign is multiplied, so you will get the, you know, upside down graph. Clear?
Yeah. Yes, sir, clear.
Okay, now we'll go to the how to find the equation of the parabola now. How to find the equation of the parabola, isn't it correct? Now let's understand this part now. Draw the figure 11.16 now. We'll try to.
Okay.
Okay, good. Now let's understand the figure 11.16 now. If you understand the figure 11.16, is the same the equation of the parabola? We are trying to derive the equation of this parabola now. Simple parabola, right? Now, how does this parabola work, correct?
Yeah.
Now, let's understand that. Y square
is
equal to 4ax, right? Simple. Now, in this case, what and all we can see in this part? So, we have a focus that is a comma 0. That is in the positive x axis, right? That's why the a comma a is positive, a comma 0 from the vertex O. And we have the directrix line. Let's say this is the, you know, L line, which is how much, what is the distance from the x-axis, it is basically it's a minus a, is it? A distance away from the origin. So the m will be coordinate of m is what? M coordinate is minus a, isn't it? Minus a comma 0,
yeah.
Isn't it? Right, m coordinate is 0. So basically your equation of line will be x is equal to minus a. So this directrix line is x is equal to minus a is parallel to the y-axis. So you draw the blue line, that line is anyway parallel to the y-axis, which is this, and this line becomes a directrix to you. Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, now we want you look at this. Basically, whatever the focus we are taking, no, that same distance we have to take from the vertex in the backward direction. So 0 to f is the distance is a. Okay, this I will also mention so that it will be much clearer to you, you know. Okay, so I'll mention from here. So look at the, I'll just send you this picture so that you can notice what changes we have done in this, so that it becomes easier for you to understand. Correct? So always the directrix will be from the focus, whatever the distance you are taking from the origin to the focus, the same distance you have to take it from the that much distance. So basically distance is how much? 2a distance. 2a distance away from the focus. That a directrix line will always be a distance away from the focus. Clear?
Yeah.
Between what is the distance of MF now?
Clear.
MF will be equal to 2a.
It's 2a.
Got 2A. It right? Clear? Next. Now, as per the as per the definition of the parabola, we know that we'll consider any random point on the parabola is P. This coordinate we don't know, then we'll assume that coordinate is x comma y. Correct?
Yeah.
Now, as per the definition parabola, the, you know, the distance, perpendicular distance from direct P to the line L should be equal to the distance of P from the F, isn't it? So,
yes, sir.
PF should be equal to PB, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
PF should be equal to PB. Now, you know the distance formula. Use the distance formula and get the substitute the values, or it can be also written as PF square is equal to PB square. That will be easy. No need to take the square root also.
Yes, yeah.
You can take the find the distance same, then square root distance also has to be same. Isn't it? Yeah. So distance is same, then square root distance also has to be same. So PF square should be equal to PB square. Now apply the formula now. What is PF square? PF is, so use the distance formula and then substitute and try to get the equation. See whatever get cancelled, cancel it off, and then get the equation of the parabola. So something like this you will be getting. You should get this equation. Let's see. Are you getting the same equation or not?
Yeah, here y square equals 4ax.
Excellent. Now a is positive here. Can you see the a is positive here? A is greater than 0. Right?
Yeah.
So y square is equal to 4ax. So this becomes the equation of the parabola now. Clear?
Okay. Yes, sir, clear.
Excellent. Okay. So any point on this equation of the line, any point on this parabola, right? Coordinate will satisfy this equation called y square is equal to 4ax, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so PF is equal to PB, so we already got that sense, so we equated and then we got the answer, okay? Now, next part is, A is greater than 0, A is less than 0, okay, so, let's understand the other part now. In this case, what will happen now? Yeah. The standard equation of the parabola have the focus on the one of the coordinate of the vertex. Okay, yeah, we didn't discuss this part. Figure 11.15 B and C and D part, right? B, C, D part we need to discuss, right? Now, in this B, C, D part, we have y square is equal to minus 4ax, x square is equal to 4ay, and x square is equal to minus 4ay. So, same thing. 11.15 B, C, D. When whatever the figure we have
just have to change the value. 16
we have done, right? So when you use the anything, we can use the same thing. We can just do the B part also, C part also, D part. So basically equation will remain the same. So what kind of equation you'll get? Y square is equal to minus 4ax, x square is equal to 4ay, and x square is equal to minus 4ay. So these are the standard equations for all the whatever the four figures we discussed, it'll become the same thing. So your method is same. Perpendicular line distance should be equal to focus line distance. Clear?
Yes, sir. Clear.
Okay. So here, we just need to, now let's go back to the, you know, understanding of the figure, because sometimes when the equation, the parabola equation is given to you, how we will draw the part, that we'll try to understand that. Y square is equal to 4ax whenever is there. So just assume that y square, whichever the square term is there, you take that and equate, make the, you know, which is the degree one, make that as a subject. Example, y square is equal to 4ax means x is, has a degree one, y is a degree two. Make the x as a subject.
Yes, sir.
So x will be equal to y square by 4a. Correct. Now, even if we give the negative and positive values of y, x will be always positive. So x will be positive is there in the first and the fourth quadrant. First and the fourth quadrant, x is positive, correct? So the graph will be on the, so graph will be on the, you know, right hand side, isn't it? Graph will be always on the right hand side. Clear? Next, y square is going to negative minus 4ax. So x is equal to minus y square by 4a. So x is negative in second and third quadrant. So, your parabola curve will be on the left hand side. Clear? Now, x is equal to 4ay.
Yes, sir.
Third one. X square is equal to 4ay. So, y is equal to x square by 4a. So, y is positive. See, x is negative or positive. Y is anyway positive. So, y is positive in the second and the third quadrant. So, curve will be upper, parabola will be upside. Parabola will be upper side. Similarly, x square is negative minus 4ay, negative 4ay, then y is equal to x square by minus 4a. So, it will be below the x axis, third and the fourth quadrant. Y is negative in third and fourth quadrant, so curve, the parabola will be opening into the negative y axis. Understood?
Okay, sir. Yes,
any questions, understood. Any doubts till now?
No, sir.
Okay, so symmetric, we got it. Okay, now we'll go to something on the lattice rectum. So, one more things we want to define in terms of this part, right? Let's draw the figure. Find the length of the lattice rectum of y square is equal to 4ax, okay? So, what is called lattice rectum? Draw the figure 11.17. One more terminology here and we'll explain this part. Then we'll clear to you, huh? So latus rectum is nothing but the line segment perpendicular to the axis of the parabola through the focus and whose end points lie on the parabola.
Okay.
So basically at one point you will come across, right? In the parabola, as per that, one point you will come across that that will become perpendicular to the focus. Correct? At one point you will get the line which is perpendicular to the focus. That point on the parabola, that distance AF, that point on the parabola will be termed as A, and the distance AF is called the that distance AF is nothing but 2A distance away from it. So no, that AC, sorry, no. So that means AC is equal to AF, correct? As per the definition, AC should be equal to AF, because the distance from the perpendicular line should be equal to the distance from the focus. Now AF is basically perpendicular to the x-axis, to the not vertex, it's on the focus basically. Clear? So parabola is symmetric with respect to x-axis, so AF will be equal to FB, and so the AB length of the AB is called the latus rectum of the parabola. So whatever the AF length you are getting, twice of that AF will become the AB, isn't it?
Yeah.
So AB, the term, because AB is, you know, AB, AF is symmetrical with FB. Okay, any point on the A, you can easily find the point on the B, because the distance of FA and should be same as distance will be FB. Clear? Because this parabola is symmetrical. Correct? Anything distance from the F to the A should be same distance from the F to B also. And you already got the, you know, AC is equal to AF. And you already know that, you remember the distance, okay. I'll just, we didn't draw this figure, no? So we'll try to understand the figure only. Then it will be more clear to you. So what I meant is here is, let's say this distance is A and this distance is also A, correct? So now what is the FM distance? Now I'll just tell you this distance. Yeah, I sent you this part. Just check this part. So AC will be equal to 2A, correct?
Yeah.
So AC is equal to 2A. What is AC? AC is nothing but the MF only. Correct?
Hmm.
Now we say AC is equal to AF. Then AF also equal to 2A. Now twice of AF will be equal to AB is equal to 4A, isn't it?
Yeah.
So latus rectum, the length AB is called the 4A. Is it clear?
Yes, that's clear.
Huh? Clear?
Yeah.
Okay, no problem.
Yes, sir.
Understood? Fine, Vijay. Just revise this, whatever we have done it. And then we'll continue with the example 5 next time. Is it okay? Just revise it, Bob. And in case you have any doubt in this part, because it's very important. Once you understand this concept, the questions will be much easier to, you know, handle it. Okay? Because concept has to be very clear. What do you call latus rectum? All 4-5 terminology which you remember right now, just practice by yourself. Okay? And then we'll continue. Is it okay?
Yeah.
Fine, Vijay. So let's close it now. We'll continue. Okay?
Okay.
Yeah. Bye.
Bye, sir.
Bye.